Well, you know, we made mistakes from the opening kickoff. We made them on offense. We turned the football over too many times on offense, and we gave up too many plays on defense, and we made mistakes in the secondary. And they capitalized. Every time we made a mistake, they capitalized. And that's the thing that we didn't want to happen going into this particular ball game, but it did. And at the same time, you know, we're going to have to add players to the mix in order to compete at that level, and we know that. Well, you try to find any positives in this ball game, but the good thing about it is our kids never stop fighting, and they fought for four quarters. So that's the positive in it. The negative side of it is we have to forget what happened last Saturday and get ready for this weekend, because now it's conference play, and we're talking about South Carolina State and making a trip into Orangeburg, which is going to be ultimately tough to do. So, you know, we're getting focused now for South Carolina State, and I think that's the only focus we have. Well, you know, as we move on as coaches, learning our personnel and learning what we have, we've only been in this situation 6 months. So as we go, you know, we're going to play to our strengths, whatever those strengths may be. Of course, we may want to run the football, and that's one of my biggest philosophies is being able to run it. But we may ultimately have to throw the football in order to be able to run the football. So we'll do what we have to do to make sure that we can get the mix right. I tell you what, a 17-year-old kid, he hasn't turned 18 as of yet, still a true freshman. I joked with him the other day, and I told him, I said, your GPA is probably the worst I've ever seen one, a 0.00, and you have no hours. So, but he's a really, really good young man, a very, very good football player, one that we did want a redshirt. But, you know, at the same time, we needed to help at that position with Justin being down, and we needed one to step up. And he has the ability to energize our football team, and he has the ability to up his level of play. And that's what we're looking for out of players, the ability to change and adapt and move their level of play up to the next level. Well, you know, the one thing about the Wiley kid is that that's a kid that we ultimately recruited when I was at Winston, and I think it went down between South Carolina State and us at Winston. But there's a lot of respect for his game. You know, he's a young man that has matured now, certainly can throw the football, but has an exceptional speed. So the one thing that we have to do is just try to mix coverages up a little bit and hope we don't blow a coverage trying to mix it up and put a little pressure on him. We got to figure out a way to get pressure on the quarterback, and we were not able to do so on this past Saturday. So we got to change some things up on the defensive side to figure out how to get pressure on him. Well, you're absolutely right, and this is a very tough football team that we're going to play. Of course, you know, they're 1-2, but people probably fail to realize that they opened up with two FBS schools. So certainly put a different spin on things. So they're going to be ultimately prepared to play. Buddy Pugh has always been that way. It's tough going into Orangeburg to play and try to get a win. I've coached there before, so I know what the people in Orangeburg expect. But at the same time, if we go in and play without making mistakes and shooting ourselves in the foot, then we stand a chance of coming away with a win.